Hello, this is Simon Chilambo here. Rainbow broadband. Nelson Mandela, Chillax, 27 years in prison. Apartheid venom fails to corrode his bones. Apartheid itetis tosa. Ayazuguti aigobegilens imbi. Robben Island made the man on the one hand, broke the man's soul on the other, threw his boxing gloves to the sea lions, Chillax, ashore. Gather no weeds, hammer away rocks abound on the island, protective gear, a remote idea, rock chips and dust mess your eyes up, you can't cry freedom, you can't see. When you couldn't care about curving freedom out of stone, rock chips and dust clog your nostrils up, you can't smell the misery of the people in the air. Inasmuch as post-Mandela's death, people can't smell corona, that way it can't be real, and the people continue to die like flies. Inasmuch as Mandela's liberation of the people of Mzansi is fake for sure, this is the land Mandela sold away to white men's burden, legacy perpetrators. They call them white monopoly capital buffoons, to whom Gupta brothers came and added color and spice and pocketed Mandela sellouts, inheritors, dazed in Agarbati smoke clouds, when you thought weed was bad, eroding Mzansi land, left, right and center for sure, with their cupidity machines thinking that gravy train, conspicuous consumption symbols, Ferrari and Maserati, exhaust the polenta to the people of Mzansi for sure. Meanwhile, Maybach leverages mortuaries competing for corpses around Mzansi for sure. Some corpses drapped in Johann Rupert's jewelry empire vanity chains, stones upon which studded wouldn't feed even insects and worms, as is the nature of stones. Who knows that better than Northern Desert's pyramids? Perhaps we should all head south to detox white man's burden feces on Robben Island for the elusive redemption of Africa burning in self-perpetuatory white man's burden transgenerational trauma self-annihilatory black curse. Some look up to the pyramids of Egypt, findings in the bowels of which only confirm our once upon a time grandeur. That's all. Non-revolutionary static pride in ancient times, disconnected with realities of our times, just keeps us sinking beneath our rivers. In the age of global warming, not of Mandela's doing, the Nile shall swallow the pyramids one of these days. What you gonna do when the pyramids are gone? The Congo shall flood the belly of Africa someday. Who'll be there to say anything? Whoever will be looking to find Lumumba's bones floating around shall be doing so in vain. The Zambezi is coming, the Kariba Dam's already getting weary. What you gonna do when Sharon Stone's King Solomon's mines are gone? Wake up, dude, put 70 university degrees to good use for once, for goodness sake. It's okay, the greenback's on the streets. Mzansi runs still real money for sure. Got Mandela's face on it, ne? Wathi, pamberi nentontoni umntu. O Thixo wethu, oy, Nkosi sikelela. Revolutionary Africa been at war with itself from during anti-colonial struggle days. Civil wars continued upon independence attainment, free at last to play out white men's burden, transgenerational trauma, self-annihilatory black curse games to this day. Freedom is a relative state in African states, basis the result of state dysfunctionality in Africa as elsewhere is a constant. tyrants everywhere, including America, staying alive, feeding on murder in all its execution variabilities. Survivors rot in jail, people endure suffering in all its construction variables. People dream of life supporting freedoms elsewhere. Since Mandela's betrayal of the African self-determination cause 27 years ago, Mzansi for sure has yet to degenerate to levels of truly liberated free Mother Africa, making a mockery of Pan-Africanist dreams. When free Mother Africa's people give up on the miseries of their tyrannical, genocidal, war-torn lands of once upon a time ancient megastar warrior kings as accessible to today as the horizon of history, choose to rather not get roasted walking the Sahara, drown treading the Mediterranean, there's a rainbow broadband linking the poles of Africa from the Atlas to the Cape, making a joke of Cecil Rhodes' Cape to Cairo highway dream. Following this rainbow, many an African soul crushed under own meaning of true self-annihilatory African liberation land in awesome Gauteng. Cradle of humankind grounds, a city of gold, mystical below and above the ground. People begin to breathe here. People grow wings here. People reach all corners of Mzansi for sure from here. People's dreams come true here. The rest is magic. Afro-xenophobia comes and goes now and then, Mzansi for sure, playing out its own version of white men's burden, transgenerational trauma, self-annihilatory black curses, call it divide and rule devices. I've asked before, who's better, who's worse? Same difference, same shit. The southernmost tip of the Africa long broadband rainbow touches Robben Island in this lament here. Nelson Mandela legacy spirit infused, I lay my head on the anvil in this lament here. I proclaim that Africa's future is anchored here. Prove me wrong if you can. Hammer my brains out if I'm wrong. Come along, join the Rainbow Nation's march to go detox itself of white men's burden feces on Robben Island for the elusive redemption of Africa burning in self-perpetuatory white men's burden transgenerational trauma, self-annihilatory black curse, singing Africa unite. Desmond Tutu Nyua, may his soul rest in eternal power of love and peace. It's all in the rainbow of humanity's diversity, vibrancy. Embrace it as it garrisons you in Mzansi for sure. Desmond Tutu's magical rainbow nation, where tyrants cave in under the law, whilst the white man's burden fishes detox movement goes on, bloody messy as it gets, as it was in the beginning.